Is this why all the Taiwanese are so beautiful? And they look so young and their skin, everything's so perfect. This is the secret, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a secret.
Every road I have been on here is amazing. Out place, there is just traffic coming every half an hour and I just couldn't sleep. So yesterday was a pretty full day. I packed up, I left at 8 a.m. Then I was going all day and I hiked and I was just like go. And 8 o'clock rolled around and it was dark and cold and I didn't feel like setting up camp. So I treated myself to a really mediocre yet very expensive hotel at the top. But I tell you, it was worth every penny because I was dying last night. It's been a while since I've done a big trip like this, and my body's kind of feeling it. So, and I'm really pushing because I've got just a tiny bit of time. So, yeah. Anyway, speaking of time, we gotta get on the road. Anyways, I better go. I got cheated. Tonight I'm heading to a very nice hotel with a stunning view, apparently, of a waterfall and sunset from their rooftop. So, wow, more bikers! I kind of want to get there before dark because I want to enjoy that. Better hustle, hustle! Down the mountain. What's really cool is that Taiwan has a huge bike culture and I can absolutely see why. I mean, these roads are amazing for two wheels. All the bikers are kind of congregated over at the 7-Eleven parking lot here. Every bike, all sorts of bikes. Right now I am so glad. So everyone told me to take a scooter across Taiwan. They're like, it is so small, you don't need a big bike. No. A scooter does not do these roads justice. It's so much fun. For anyone who rides out there, you will obviously understand and get this. It is a dream. It is an absolute dream to ride here. And I'm not just sugarcoating that for the video. It's so good.
Between the Pacific Ocean plate and the Eurasia plate, which are the two top largest plates in the whole world. They are colliding with each other, so that's why Taiwan grew so fast. Within 20 million years, we grew from ground zero all the way to 4,000 meters. You get an idea that it's how the stream cutting through the mountains and great gorges and different mountain ranges here and there.
Nice.
So, together,
so you take tours here?
Yeah. It's actually called remote Asia travel. Okay.
In your opinion, what's the best road in Taiwan?
Okay, I would say it's number 21.
You guys meet from all across Taiwan?
Yeah, meet up here. I'm from Taichung.
So now you're going home?
Yeah. Take a break and go home.
Yeah. Did you have a good day?
Yeah.
Good ride?
Yeah, so fucking exciting.
It is a hot day. I gotta protect my skin. but not quite as humid on this side. It's pretty good. I heard that farther south you go, it's not so humid, so that's nice. Oh my, what am I doing? Whoa. All right, southward bound. Got a good few hour ride ahead of me. I have no idea what to expect, as always, but excited for the road ahead. Here we go. Walk. Bye guys. We're biking again. I wasn't in such a hurry. I want to explore all these little towns, but the next couple days I might have a chance to always settle a bit more. Oh, I'm guessing a bike. I can go ahead of everyone, can't I?
This small town I was invited to is called Caoling. It's a cute little village nestled in the heart of the mountains. And I was staying at a traditional old house that was converted into a family guest house.
Is Chen?
This was an original mountain home used in the 60s, and it was recently remodeled into this lovely guest house. As long of a day as it is, being a traveling content creator, I still have to sit down and work every night. This is what you don't see behind the scenes. From charging my equipment, organizing footage, and doing admin. After a super long day, I need things to go as smoothly as possible. And the last thing I need is to be worried about getting hacked. My entire life is online, from personal to career to banking and more. One wrong move and I'm in big trouble. In my line of work, I can't afford this, so I never travel without using a VPN. And today's video just happens to be sponsored by NordVPN.com. NordVPN has recently launched their threat protection, offering you security against cyber threats by blocking trackers, malicious ads, harmful websites, and infected files. In this day and age, you really can't be too careful, and NordVPN just gives you that extra peace of mind, especially after a long day. Aside from some very important security features, it also helps you save money and do your online shopping. I recently discovered that you can actually save money on flights by changing your location. NordVPN offers a variety of servers all over the world, so you can easily find the best deal on your next travels. Last year, I tried to buy my mom's Christmas present online, and the Canadian website would not let me access the site from Pakistan, and I couldn't forget my mom at Christmas. Luckily, I was able to change my location to Canada, so I was able to complete the purchase, and my mom was very happy about that. So get your exclusive NordVPN deal here using my code RosieGabrielle. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. What have you got to lose? Try it today. Thanks, Nord.
Oh my gosh, this is such a cute, quirky little town. So the young fellow that I'm staying with, it's a family-run guest house that I'm staying at. And so his grandmother works at this little shop here. His mother works over here. His aunt and uncle are in the restaurant. And over here, we got some rock and karaoke happening that I think I might join them after, but first, I am starving, so I'm gonna go have some food at the restaurant here.
Go over here for the rice.
Alright, wow. What a feast here. This all looks so amazing.
Cameliea oil is very healthy and good for our body. Yeah.
And it's produced locally here?
Yeah, it's local. It's our calling for this oil.
So hungry and really cool. I've got something new. So here in Caoling, they produce this oil here. It's I'll get back to you on the name. It is a very special oil. Chen was just explaining to me that it's very good for your digestion, gastrointestinal. They actually put it on their rice, on their food, and if you're having any sort of stomach upset, you just take a spoon. It's kind of like, it's got a really nice nutty flavor. Oh my gosh, how am I gonna eat all this food? Coronarius, ginger fly.
Yeah.
Oh, it's made of a flower.
Yeah, yeah. Made of flour. You can eat that.
The egg good. Is made out of a flower. Wow, this is so amazing. Yeah. Thank you so much. Wow. Where do I start? So it's really cool here, actually, how they eat. So they have a small bowl of rice, and then they will add different things to the rice, and then eat it in a small little bowl.
And all the dish is grown by my grandma.
All of it is made by your grandma,
this flour or your dish, all.
Wow, I have to meet your grandma after.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Wow. Okay, here we go. So we add a little bit of this greens. That looks delicious. Wow. And they're rocking the karaoke next door. Oh wow. This is really good. It's got like a peanut sauce to it. Wow. That is really, really, really nice. I think I'm gonna eat a lot tonight. this egg made out of, I'm gonna say it wrong, Cameliea flower. It's made of flour. It's actually slightly floral. That is really nice. Amazing food. I have to say, this is probably the best food I've had in Taiwan so far. And it's all made by Chen's grandma. I'm messing up. I'm stuck. Oh, that was so good. Shall we?
This is Chen. He runs and operates Caoling Dai, the family guest house I'm staying in, and is a super host. His grandmother is the one who grew all of the ingredients for the food, and she has a small shop next door. And this is her. She was super cute. Together, they harvest and produce the Cameliea oil. It's cold pressed and available to buy. This is a rare specialty of this area called Caoling. I love how everything is family run. Next, I got to visit more of his family who ran another shop a few doors down.
So in Taiwan, we will have a cup of tea after dinner. Yeah. It's a traditional
usually tea. Huh. Yeah. Taiwan is very famous for their oolong green tea.
High mountain oolong tea. Is there a special way to drink it or just? Oh wow, it's got a very strong flavor.
But one thing I didn't know they were famous for was also their coffee, which you can find everywhere in the mountains here. And this family also happens to have their own coffee farm.
And this is produced locally here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's a locally they play by themselves.
Okay, and is it your family that makes it?
Yeah. Do you want to have a try?
Sure.
The coffee, okay.
Yes, I would love it.
Hello.
Hi.
And I was about to find out just how serious they are about coffee.
The light roast beans, you have to have higher temperature, then the smell will be good.
Wow, what a smell.
We've got the coffee master. Dun, 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 dun.
It was quite the meticulous process. I have never seen coffee prepared like this with such precision and care. I was told that the water had to be a specific temperature. If it was any less, the coffee would be ruined. This family grows and handpicks every bean and then dries them to perfection. It's a real art. Everything that touches the coffee should be heated so not to taint the taste.
I didn't know that there was like an art to coffee, so much is going into this.
Yeah.
Oh, this beats Starbucks any day.
Oh, it's better than Starbucks.
Yeah.
And now it was time to try this perfectly prepared cup of coffee.
It doesn't work out. Thank you so much.
Okay, open your
Oh wow, it's got a completely different taste, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's very fruity.
Yeah.
It's fruity. It's light roast. That's very nice. Give you 5 stars.
They also sold bottles of the Cameliea oil and shared some additional health benefits and uses for it.
Chen was saying the grandma puts it on her hair.
It's
good for the skin.
That's
the soap as well.
Yeah,
oh wow, you have everything. I'm gonna go shopping tomorrow.
Yeah.
Gifts, perfect. Is it Is this why all the Taiwanese are so beautiful? And they look so young and their skin, everything's so perfect.
Yeah, it's a secret.
Next, they showed me how they cook with it. It was a very special traditional dish, specifically from this town, Caoling. They said it's very healthy for you. It was simply made of just a few ingredients: camellia oil, chicken, a bit of salt, and a lot of ginger. It looked and smelled amazing. I couldn't wait to try it.
Alright, so apparently if you do not try this dish, you have not officially been to Charlie.
That's not all for me, is it?
Yolanda was telling me earlier that when a woman gets birth, for 1 month after, they feed her this, because apparently it's really good at restoring the stomach, for the health, for everything. And the name, again, you're going to have to remind me.
Gu cha yo.
Ji.
Yeah, perfect.
Ginger is like crispy.
Mm-hmm. So this one for you.
All for me.
Yeah.
That's really good.
It's so crispy.
I never would have thought that you could eat fried ginger. But it's really nice. Very good. Yeah, I didn't have much luck with the food in Taipei. I really like the food here.
Yeah. It's simple, but so
much flavor.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so fresh.
Mm-hmm. You are a chopstick tailor.
I'm from Vancouver. We have a big Asian community. In Vancouver, my favorite food is sushi. This is actually really good. And I'm not saying this because they're in front of me, but this is actually the best food that I have had in Taiwan so far. It is really, really, really good. Alright guys, I'm gonna stay here, okay?
What an amazingly beautiful experience this was with this family. And such delicious food. This is what travel is all about, these unique and wonderful connections. And tomorrow, Liz takes me to visit their family's coffee farm. Stay tuned for the next episode.